What is going on, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome.
We'll be right back. Connected. Sound muted.
Hello. Hello, 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 hello. Yes, that's what's gonna happen. What is going on, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to an Esea open match between CSG Team Purple and We Suck at Dota. I am your host and your caster for this evening, Mr. Hick. Today, this match will be on DE Dust 2. Both teams today are currently holding their own very well in this Esea open season, and Team Purple will be using one stand-in today, that's Orion. What is going on, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to an Esea open match between CSG Team Purple and We Suck at Dota. I am your host and caster for this evening, Mr. Hick. This match will be on DE Dust 2. Both teams today are looking very good. They're also holding their own really well in this season with an even score line. Team Purple today will be using one stand-in. That's Orion on their team today. Also, so this won't be their full roster. Also, overall, these two teams definitely seem ready to show us some great epic gameplay, and I'm very excited about this. So, Dust 2 in general, this is going to be very awesome to watch because this map relies a lot on plays. A lot of shots have to be hit. A lot of strats you can actually play, but in the end, it really does depend on the players. So, hopefully these teams are going to show us something epic today. I'm very excited about that. Now that the knife round is over, we're going to see the side pick coming out. Most of the teams decide to go CT side, but this can be a very big CT or T-sided map if you actually play this correctly. And like I said, it does depend on the gun battles. And now they have chosen, it looks like CSG Team Purple will be starting on T-side. Now, we are going live into the first round. This is the pistol round of this match. It all begins here. Looking like a full Kevlar buy and some utility on the terrorist bodies here. CT's definitely getting some armor and utility, and also a kit on their body, so they're definitely looking to play as best they can here. Terrorist kind of going towards more of a mid-take here, looking for control. CT's playing a 2-1-2 setup here. Now it's all slow. All gone quiet. Waiting on an execute or something to happen. The terrorists have moved down into mid. The aggression on the cap by the CT players here is going to be kind of challenging. Now he's completely running out of mid. That's Lucca coming out with 2-3! Picking up instant! Already starting this game off amazing. Walmart going to answer back on a joke. Big plays from the CT side here. Archer will be picking up the frag on the Lulnut. And the Kukli shot from Tank Sip. This is already turning into an epic match. Just crazy shots already happening from the CTs. And now it's a 1v3 for Archer. Archer taking the gun battle here on the Tech. Is he going to be able to get it? No. Tech shuts him down. We Suck at Dota takes the pistol round. And that's the win for them. No plant for the T's either, so that's definitely going to put them in an economic situation they don't want to be in. If they can't get a bomb plant this round, then it's going to be more of a fourth round buy for them. CT's going to absolutely rack up on their buy. And now this round has started. CT's going for more of the 3-1-1 setup here. Terra's kind of moving down and towards mid. We're going for that cat rush. They are going to have Tech 9 armor, so that's what they were going to work for. Joke is going to pick up the first frag. He can't get the next one. He is tagged in the head. Now Savage getting the Deagle shot onto Lucca. That's Walmart also picking up a Tech 9 shot onto two of the CTs. It's now 2 versus 4 for these CTs. Lulnut going to answer back on the Archer. And now 2 versus 3 for these CTs on a full retake. Terrorist completely grouped up on the side here. This is still possible for these counter terrorists to pick this up. Savage completely coming back towards long. Probably playing the post plan here. These CTs are going to double up onto the catwalk. Smoke is going to come out. Flash coming through Walmart in a very good position to stop this. It gets 1 and 2. That's Walmart with the 4K this round. Ending that. That force buy for Cyberstorm Gaming. Team Purple 1-1 scoreline. Now CTs are going to be in a bad economic situation this round. It has turned the tables on them. And this is your score after the first two rounds for both teams. So now this next round is getting underway. We're probably going to see some kind of rush coming up on the CTs. Or looking more actually like they're playing the same setup they did the last round. T's have been playing more of a slow mid-take, trying to get control, pushing catwalk. And that's definitely turning out well for them. Really close play here by the CT on long. Orion is going to have the bomb outside of long, but CTs are aggressed pretty well across the map. One aggressed up on cat by himself and one close long. They are able to leave that player at long close, but he's pushed into the doors here. He's going to try and catch one off guard, but they are holding passive. T's are playing this very smart, actually watching for a push, hoping that they're going to mess up, completely get caught off guard, and it's going to really screw them over. Still, no push actually happening. We're still not seeing anything come through here yet. Quiet all across the board. Saucy going to be playing more of a CT's passive setup here. Just looking to spot for info. Now the mid smoke coming down. Going up the catwalk through the terrace. Are going to get the entry frag on a joke. That's one down for them. And that leaves the A-bomb completely open. Counter terrorists are put into a full retake. Probably going to have to look for some kind of gun here. That's the best option they have. CT's playing close to the smoke here. He is going to catch Savage off guard. That's Saucy picking up that gun. So now it's a 4 versus 4. Still looking kind of possible for the CT's if they play this retake very well. Now moving up the catwalk, Walmart in a very good offset position here. He's going to get some shots in, but there's 3 CTs on catwalk, one pushing up into the CT spawn. Adam's going to get Lulnut, but Saucy and Lulnut do pick up 2 of the Team Purple members. Adam going to answer back to Tech, and now it's a 2 versus 1. Only Lucca left. Adam and Archer, they do end up taking him down. That is the end of that round. Team Purple is going to take it away, making the scoreline 2-1. For Team Purple. Some great gameplay coming out here. We are seeing some cool shots happen. That pistol round was absolutely insane, but looking at the CT's eco, still not really going to be able to get the best buy here, but they're going to, one of them look like he forced. It's kind of weird. You wouldn't expect just one to force. Maybe their communication's not there, but we'll have to find out what's actually going to happen. Playing these CTs in that same sort of setup again, more heavy on the A, completely leaving mid open. They don't have the eco to actually handle this, so this is going to be quite close and difficult for them. Lulnut, he's the only one with an actual gun here. Playing B anchor by himself. Kind of a smart play. Maybe they meant to do that. Still holding passive all around the terrorists here. Still waiting for something to happen. Sorry about the lag on the stream. My internet will fix pretty soon. It shouldn't be doing this all night. I'm sorry about that. The issues will fix. It should stabilize. Alright, we're now back into the round. Walmart going to throw a smoke, a couple of utility out on the B-bomb site. Lulnut is going to be able to take this gunfight, pull the CTs away from the A-bomb, and that completely catches them off guard. Team Purple acting on it, but Tech is going to get the Deagle headshot onto Archer. This is not looking very amazing for the CTs, but the terrorists just probing them right there, making them come out of their position. Savage pushed way really far up. Tech is going to get caught off guard by him, and that's pinking it. A 2 versus 4 for the CTs. 2 rifles in their hands, though. Are they going to be able to save it? That's Walmart going for the spray down. That's 1. That's 2. That's the 2 headshots for him. Shutting down the team, and now it's 3-1. Purple ahead. Dota still trying to come back. With that weird rifle buy, I feel like that hurt them very badly after losing that round. It's going to put them in a difficult situation. They're not actually going to be able to get the best buy now. Lulnut going to have to go with a Swag 7 instead. So this round, AR going to be able to buy up an op Archer as well. And this is going to be the first real gun round that we've seen so far. CT's playing that same sort of setup again. With the terrorists playing aggression all around the map. And that's Walmart with the tail leg from the opper there. Archer going to catch Lulnut off guard. They are moving out of the B site with the bomb. Saucy trying to get some info. Maybe catch one off guard. Adam Lurker here is going to take down by Joke. Now the T's are all committed, except Savage. He is going to be in mid, but all the CTs are lined up outside of the doors here. Are they going to be able to do anything about this? Using their utility here, the terrorists are trying to stall this retake. Orion trying to play as much aggro as he can, but not really going to happen. Now the CTs are moving, and that's two frags already from them. Two versus four for Team Purple. CTs are into the bomb site. Orion is going to get the lurking shot onto Saucy. It's not going to help much, though, now. Archer, last one in the side. He's going to get caught out by the boxes opping. The kit, it's not going to look good here. Is he going to be able to stop it? Archer is taken down. The defuse comes through. Orion not able to stop that. It is going to be left for him to save the op, though. CT's playing that very well with that stick. They did completely retake that very well. Stacking completely on the doors. Terrorists are not able to really make much of a play happen there, and I think that came back to bite them. So now we're put on a 3-2 score line. Team Purple still able to buy. We're going to be able to drop some rifles to their teammates. CT's definitely going to get a good buy now. We're going to see some more strats coming out from here. CT's going for an early long aggression and then falling back off. Kind of like a normal Dust 2 setup from them. T's are just playing so slow, looking to pull some aggression from these CTs, pull them out of position, and then, you know, completely take them out. That's what they've been doing this whole game, and so far it's been working pretty well. Now with the terrorists moving through lower here, that's Archer. The rest of them out towards top mid. Haven't really moved up yet. The CTs do have, like, an aggression on Cat here. Joke with the smoke is going to be able to hold most of it, but soon, these terrorists are playing so slow, letting them waste utility early on from the CTs. Now, an execute coming out from long A here. Terrorists are going to completely go for control. There's no CT there to even contest it, so they are going to get control of long. Leaving that lurker there into lower, this could be a very powerful play here. We've seen this strat happen a lot where teams just execute on a long A and then try to pull aggression with a lurker across the map, and that's exactly what they're trying to do here. They did completely back out too, leaving the player there to hold it. This is very good gameplay coming out from T-Purple here. Very smart strats. Completely getting ready to execute out of mid. Here they go. Flash just come out from the CT. Completely pop flashing and bonding the terrorist. Lucka get taken down by Archer there. Good shot by him now. Joke's going to have to frag out. That's one. That's two, and he's not able to get the third, though. This is an even scoreline, still good for these terrorists. With the lurker moving up on a long, Walmart is going to pick out Joke, and now Adam is going to pick up Tech. This is still, CT's putting into a full retake. With Adam pushing up on long like that, it really did actually help with that play. That was very smart by them to take early long control and have a player move up it slowly. They know they're playing passive and they're acting on it. That's absolutely what's winning it for them. Now, Lulnut is going to get the frag on Archer. They're pushing up Cap. Both of these CTs, Saucy and Lulnut, going for the full retake. Pop Flash coming through. Terrace on site is taken down by Saucy with that flick. Now it's a 1v2. Adam, he's got to go for it. Neither of them have their gun out. He's low HP. Both are low. One shot from both. And Adam is taken down by Lulnut. Full retake from them. And he does have a kit, so that defuse will come through, making this an even scoreline again. These teams are so close all across the board, and we're seeing such a great performance here. This is a great game so far. I'm excited to see how this is actually going to play out. So, looking at the economic situation, terrorists are going to be able to force up. They're going to have to drop some rifles again. Kind of a weird money spread throughout the team. CT's just really ready to get, or able to get some good buys. And now, terrorists are kind of lining up for more of a hold map control strat they did earlier. This was a second or third round in the game they did this, and it was very effective what they've done. Holding control of tunnels, making sure there's no pushes happening. Playing slow on top mid to execute and take control out of that. Still quiet across the map here. Not really much happening. All the terrorists just waiting for a push, seeing if the CTs are going to mess up. They're going to try and completely stop that if they do. Now the Flash is going to come out and blind Luck on B, but not really an execute. Orion is going to run out, though. Backs completely back up into the smoke, just throwing down some pre-fire here, and they're going to run out of mid now, the Terrace. Keep in mind now the aggression here by Joke on a Cat. He is taken down by Walmart. That's the entry. Completely leaving the A-bomb open again. This is such a smart play by the Terrorist. Not much they can really do. And the Savage with the pop out of mid, he is traded from Lucka, but that was a great headshot from him. They're just absolutely reading these CTs. They're able to take them down, and putting players, like, aggressing on one side of the map is making these CTs rotate their players off, and they're so fast with their execution. Tech gonna pick up Orion. It's a 3v3, and these CT retakes, though, they're strong across the board. Adam's gonna get a frag on a Lulnut. Now we're seeing one CT, and the CT spawn is gonna take out Archer. Lucka Knows there's a player on elbow. Adam's gonna have to stay crouched, trying to take out one. He's gotta isolate. Adam is taken out by Lucka. It's now 1v2 for Walmart. Walmart gets one. 1v1. Lucka does spot him out, and he takes it down. Walmart with the 1v2 clutch there. He is gonna close out the round, making this a 4-3 scoreline. Still fighting for the win. Team Purple able to hold this still. Hold their victory. Economic situation very bad for these CTs. Not gonna be able to buy. Gonna have to save. Probably buy a few pistols, and these T's are going to rack up some money now. So, the setup here is going to be very important from these CTs. If they play this the same, this could be very bad. They have to know that these T's are reading them, know that they're actually being completely forced out into the open, away from the bomb sites, so the T's can have control. But, overall, this is going to be a close one. This round just being played slow with the cat aggression by two CTs here. T is completely silent. Just waiting for pushes here. Now, it is going to be contact made here. As Tech, not able to really do anything, though. Just get a little tag on a Savage. The aggression here of the early, that close guy there, Lucka, on mid-doors is going to help out the two cat players playing aggressive. And I think that's going to be very important for if they're going to try and win this eco or get some good guns. Excuse me, then. That's how they're going to do it. Now, the boost on a cat. Joke is taking down, though. Savage, no thank you. And now, the peek by Saucy is going to take down Orion and T-Spawn. Catches him with his pants down. Lucka getting the one frag here. The one and done. And two! The P250 headshot. Shutting them down. The dinks from these CTs. Deeking Walmart, too. It's a 2v3, and it's starting to look very possible for these CTs. Completely catching him off guard. Archer is going to take down Tech. And he's going to take down Lucka, completely turning the tide for the T's. Saucy. Last man standing with the P250, stuck behind the box in CT spawn, Walmart on 5 HP. This is still possible if he can actually find a rifle somewhere. He's going to have to really make something happen. He just found a Mike 10 and a flash, so... And an op. He may actually go for the save. This is important here, what he actually judges to do. Either way he chooses, this could be what the CTs rely on for the next round. He is playing some aggressive position here towards the B doors, backs away to CT spawn. He is going for the save. Terrace are going to be able to pull this round out here. Good plays by them. The eco there was very close by the CTs. They definitely had a good chance to win it. Overall, in the end, though, it just the plays weren't there. They weren't able to make it happen all the way, and that's that. The scoreline is now 5-3. Team Purple ahead. CTs not definitely in the best money situation, but probably going to be able to get some kind of buy. They are dropping an op to their opper here. Hopefully something crazy is going to be able to be pulled out from them. Sorry about the lag. Just now seen that. It should fix itself. If it doesn't, I'm very sorry about that. This round has begun. The CTs have played an early aggression towards long with two... One aggressive cat as well. They're playing just aggressive A, passive B setup. T's are just completely operating on what they're doing, executing when they're not ready, pulling them out of position, and now they're playing slow. The peek is going to happen from Tech, riding Savage down to 70. No damage done to the CT player. Kind of catching them off guard. They've got to be ready to hit those shots. Just wait and tap them out. Now that's Joke getting one with the Swag 7, but then the Terrorists are going to answer back with two frags on them. Opening up the A bomb again. Tech's the only player towards the A side, and he's stuck in long doors. Archer does know he's there. Archer jumps, though. Looks like a complete accident, but Tech does take him down. He's punished for it. And now, 3v3 retake. This is looking good for the CTs, but Purple's going to have to pull something crazy out. And it's only one left. Orion, 1v3 here with 2 HP. Not much really going to... Oh, he's completely seen in the open, too. Tech is going to take him down. And that's the end of the round. We suck at Dota is going to pick that up. Nice plays from them there. Is actually looking very good for Team Purple with that complete opening onto the A bomb site, but these retakes from these CTs getting into the right positions is absolutely changing the game. So this next round has come. Here's the score line so far. Seeing a pretty impressive, basically average all around. Pretty good from Walmart and Lucka here, getting lots of frags. Now we're playing a sort of the same setup. Shunning mid, though, CTs. Terrorists are going to go for kind of a half-buy. Pistol armor on some, just pistols on the other. They're so slow with these plays, and I think that's what's helping them with the reads. And then Walmart taken down by Walnut. Falling op shot there. That was pretty cool. Savage going to go for the deke. Oh! Sick one deke from Savage takes down Walnut, evening up the odds. The Deagle plays here are definitely possible. These Team Purple members are not going to give it up yet. Saucy getting one team through the wall. They are not having any of that. Team Purple shutting them down with the peaks. The Deagles. So, they're going to be able to get these frags, though. That's what's important at the end. Doing the damage is going to have to pay off sooner or later. Tex kind of playing closer. There was going with the aggression, being pop flashed out. He's playing close Xbox. Archer going to catch him off guard. He takes it down with the Deagle. More Deagle plays happening. How are these terrorists going to be able to answer this? Are they going to be able to completely take control of the map? We're seeing a spread from the CTs right now. Not really stacking anywhere. One on each site, one CT spawn, going for a rotation whenever he can. Laka, he's in a very good spot to get that first frag, but the terrorists have a good number advantage right now, and that could be what wins him the round. Archer walking up elbow here. Joke doesn't even have a clue. He may get caught off guard. He does. Oh, no, Archer. He wasn't able to hit the shot. Joke does take him down. Now, terrorists completely knowing there's one at A. And the CTs have completely rotated the rotator over to A now. Only person left to handle them is Lucca. He is going to call out. He's hearing sound. The CTs are rotating now. Lucca, is he going to get caught off guard? He does. Savage takes him down. That's the entry. And they have the bomb site. Now, a 2v3 retake for these counter-terrorists. Still very possible from them, but these terrorists are definitely playing really well. That's Orion picking up the other frag on a joke. And Saucy, and a 1v3 here, left alone. No one else here to help him out. He's going to have to go for it. It looks like he wants to as well. He has 43 HP, so this is going to have to be an insane play for him. He does get one. He's taken down by Adam, though. The Deagle kills this round have been absolutely insane, and that's what won Team Purple the round. The shots through the wall were the best part, like the one Deagle through in the head, you know. God, you don't see those every day. So now, this round, coming out at this scoreline here, still looking good from both of these teams. It's pretty even overall. They're playing very well against each other. Now we're seeing an eco from the counter-terrorist. Going to go for a fast cat boost here. Complete rush from them for getting boosted. I wonder if this is actually going to work. These T's are playing like this, such a great passive setup that's actually pulling them out of guard. Now the rushing top mid. Joke is going to get the one on the frag. Or the frag on the Adam, excuse me. Orion stuck behind the car. Taken out by Saucy and then Archer. That's one op shot. Is he going to be able to take down Joke? Savage gets one. Then another one. He knew there was going to be a push. Two CTs left. They can still make something happen. One is caught off guard. Savage going to go for the shot. He threw the wall. Headshot on a Lulnut. Lucca, only person left here. 1v3. Is he going to be able to win this? He gets one, but not able to close it out. That makes it another round for Team Purple. The eco is a good idea. Great idea behind the rush. But overall, it did not pay off in the end. And I think that it was a good idea. It definitely could have worked. I think so. But the frags in the end, the T's were just waiting. They waited for the push. They backed up, let them completely extend their peaks there, and they were taken down for it. Now, next round has begun. We are looking at a full buy versus buy round. No op, though, on the CT side. They are kind of in a difficult money situation, so they can't buy up very well. Getting the FAMAS buy on a tech here, so this is going to be kind of a risky one. A lot of teams choose just to wait and buy up the op, trying to do an op setup here, but terrorists with a lot of money able to buy their ops every round, pretty much. So the CTs are going to have to play some kind of setup to abuse these rifles against the terrorists. Now the terrorists completely executing with the Xbox smoke up on a cat. They know there's an aggression, though, with that smoke being thrown by the CTs. As he's done every round, he throws that and then completely holds it. But now he's backed off towards the site with Saucy here. That's Saucy and Joke playing the A-bomb. Tech completely pushed into long A aggressive here, and now the terrorists are going for the execute into cat. Potfleff comes out. They do see the players are not there, so they're going to have to go for some kind of frag. And then he's caught off guard. Orion gets shot. He doesn't know where from, though. Is he going to be caught out? Lucca gets taken down by Archer in that spot. Orion had no clue where those bullets were coming from, but now terrorists are completely stuck up on cat, and that's the danger of this kind of execute as a terrorist team, is if the CTs are aggressive, which they're not, they're being punished for it right now. They're completely scared to do it, but stacking your players like that on one area of the map is bad. If you take too long, CTs can come up and flank you, exactly as Tech has done. But Archer does answer back to that, taking out that frag. Orion trades coming through. That's two from him, two entries on the A-bomb. Saucy is going to get one on the Adam, but it's not enough. Lulnut, 1v3. Going for more of a... He's not really sure. He actually is. Going to push up towards Cat. Maybe he's waiting on one of them to peek him. He's got to have an opening. If it does get one, then it's going to come out very well for him. Still pushing up on the Cat. Archer is taken down by Lulnut. Now 1v2. He doesn't have a kit, so I think he's just going for a lot of damage here towards the terrorist. He definitely is. Terra's stuck on the A-bomb. They're not actually going to be able to spot him out. He is going to go for the save. Terrister, one's going to go hunting. Neither of them are. They're letting him have the gun. So now that ends this round, making it an 8-4 score line for Team Purple. Looking very good for them right now. Like I said at the beginning of the match, this map can definitely be T-sided if you actually work together really well. And these guys have worked together. CTs are putting up a good resistance, though. It's very close. Just now getting pulled away, though, the scoreline by Team Purple. So this could be something different. Could be something great. And now kind of a force from these CTs with pistols and FAMAS. Only one M4 actually being bought across the board here. T's are going for more of a tunnels take here. They're going to exit completely out on the B side. That's a rush. Only one there. That's Lucka. Has the anchor with a deagle. Not able to get anything. Adam is going to entry him. No thank you. This is our bomb site. And now it's a full retake for the CTs. 4 versus 5. This could definitely be possible for them. They have a very good retake setup on this map. So going with the 3 towards B doors and 1 in tunnels, they're going to have to play this timing right because the T's are in some pretty good post plants here. Not really much control of tunnels at all, though, so that could hurt them. And the shot through the smoke on the tech, Savage, completely taking a guess and hitting him there. Retake still hasn't happened yet. CT's just kind of using some utility, not really able to go. They're not really deciding to go, excuse me. Still holding passive. They are just... Yep, that's exactly what they're trying to do, is just do some damage. He does peek Orianna's to... And Walmart gets a frag, so no damage is able to be done, and they're going to go for a full save, whatever they can. So now it's left in a 9-4 scoreline. Team Purple really making a read on them right now. This is definitely going pretty good. I really like this. This is still close, though. I think we suck at Dota can definitely pull this back. They play well on the T side, and this is probably what's going to happen. More than likely, what we're going to see is a good T-side play or setup from them. Have to see how Team Purple counters it. They're still playing this sort of same setup on these gun rounds, the CTs are, and that's exactly what Team Purple is reading them on, is this 3-1-1 setup. They're completely acting on it, executing them when they're not ready. And now he's just looking for the opening. That's Archer with the op in B tunnels. Orion's going to kind of play up close. Only one CT in B, but they've backed one off of A into CT spawn, and going to be able to get a quick rotate into B if the terrorists do go for this. Nothing really happening yet. Just waiting on a pick. Archer slowly sliding out. There's going to be one at car, though, and that's going to be difficult to really just walk out and op him, especially if Tech here actually goes to the B doors. He's going to be able to shut him down completely, and that's contact right there. Lucka's going to get one. Orion does take him down, but he's hurt. Tech tries to get a shot. He can't. He can't seem to connect anything. Archer threw the smoke on a Tech. Going to take him down. Terrorists are going to get a bomb set. Kobe coming in from Saucy. Going to take down Orion. And Archer through the smoke again. That's 2 op shots. Savage. And the 3rd from Archer. The Terrorists shutting them down. The smoke plays happening there. No thank you. We're not having that today. They completely shut them down with the op plays. Not going to even come into a retake there. CTs are just completely taken out. Now a 10-4. This is the last round of the first half. This is definitely looking good for Team Purple. But I wouldn't count the CTs out of this game yet. So now the early flash on the long here is Orion actually going to go for the execute. There's only one CT really playing, and that's Saucy. Trying to go for a pop flash. He's not going to hit anybody. He extends his peak, only gets one. Orion's going to trade him. Tech getting the scout shot on the Archer, though, so he's going to do some damage to their opper. That's some good damage. That's what you want. Ooh, joke. Only one on the A-bomb. Seeing one CT moving up into... Oh my lord, he's moving up in the elevator. The Molotov's completely pulling Joke out in the open. The spray transfer doing some damage there. 3 versus 3, still Savage. He's going to trade him out. Lucka getting the frag on a Savage. And Archer, that's one. He misses the second one. Tech does take down his teammate. Now it's a 1 versus 1. He's going to get the second one of the op. Lulnut versus Archer. Archer's in a very bad HP situation. More than likely, they've called out he's lit as well. So how in the world is this going to work out for Archer? He's going to have to do something insane. Lulnut is going to be pushing up now to the bomb site. He does have control of the bomb, but there's so much time left into the round. Archer can just go get some range on him, try and hit an op shot, and that's more than likely what he's going to have to rely on. Lulnut was peeking there on the side. He would be able to get caught off guard if Archer would be peeking it. He's trying to fake that. Wow, that's actually an insane flash there. EU flash coming out from... Oh, he's seen him. He's spotted him. He misses Archer. No. He's giving his spot away. He still can't hit him. The flash is there from Archer going onto the catwalk. Trying to show it or fake it that he's going to cat. But now Lulnut knows he's completely in long. He does counterflash him here. Still a lot of utility from Archer. If he just used it, he could Molotov off that position. But no, he's going to dry peek it. This is not going to be good if Archer can't do this. And Walnut takes him down. That's the end of the first half, people. This is a 10-5 half already. Team Purple definitely having the lead. Overall, very good gameplay from both teams, though. Now, this is where it matters. If We Suck at Dota was ever going to make a comeback, we're going to see it on this pistol round. They're going to have to make some insane plays happen. Purple absolutely going for the good reads on them. I think that was really what helped them in the end on the T side. And they also did overall frag pretty well. So we did see from the first pistol round that We Suck at Dota was pretty insane at hitting some crazy USP shots. But now giving them the Glocks, this could completely turn the tide for them. And I'm so glad the lag is fixed. I'm sorry about that stream. Internet has absolutely had some problems. But it looks good now, so we are ready to go. These Esea halves are so long. I guess they have to actually ready up. I'm not sure about that. The auto director really not the best thing to cast with either, so we're having to rely on that right now. I can't really work two things at once. Walk and chew gum is not possible. Both of these teams overall, though, playing very well. Scores aren't going to show up right now. There was, at the beginning, one player on each team really kind of pulling away with the score. But like I said in the beginning, I really do think that in the end, the players who frag the best are going to have the win on this map. And we've seen some great frags from both teams, but it could completely turn out different. Still into a timeout here, a pause, waiting on that second half. Maybe they're talking strats. That's what they need to be doing. They have to think this out. It has restarted, and we are now going live into the second half of this match. Team Purple, are you going to be able to take this away? Or will it be We Suck at Dota completely coming back and winning this game? Who will be victorious? We will see soon. So now the pistol round is beginning. Terrorists are going to get mostly a Kevlar buy with some utility, and CT's going for that same sort of Kevlar with the kit and one smoke. I'm curious to see how they're going to do this. Going for a big A stack, actually. Three towards long. Going to go for control over that. Terrorists are actually going to come out long. We're going to see a shooting range happen here, people. Pop flash coming out, going to blind off that player. They're out already. No shots even happening. Now the shots have happened, but nothing really doing anything. Savage and Adam going to get two shots. Tech is going to get one, but still not enough. Adam with another one. Adam with another. Oh, my. Adam. I think that was a 4K from him there. Oh my, the USP play from him was insane. He's done. He said, no, this will not be how this works, Dota. I'm sorry, but we're going to show you how to also play the pistol round with the USPs, and now he's just getting shut down. They're not going to be buying third unless they can somehow get a bomb plant right now. Probably what they're going to be going for. Didn't force up Tech 9 armor. They're just completely saving, so I think that's what they're going to try to do. Probably a smart idea. Completely bombing, running out with the Glocks. And the team kill coming out. Saucy going to kill Lucca, but only frag really coming out is going to be Saucy, and CT shutting them down. That's another round for Team Purple. Still not going to be able to get a good buy. They didn't get a bomb plant, so this is not enough to really buy AKs. CTs are really, really in a good economic situation to counter this. I feel like they should have probably went for that Tech 9 armor in that second round to try to win that. Instead of going for the save. But we will see how this works. CT's playing a very spread out setup here. 2-1-2. Heavy mid. Two terrorists actually playing into the tunnels here. We're going to see terrorists doing the same thing Team Purple was. Staying up towards top mid. Kind of like a default you see on Dust 2 nowadays. Completely quiet across the map. Everyone playing passive. Just waiting on pushes. The T's are trying to see if Purple's going to mess up. But Purple's just not, they're not going to do this. I think they're just going to hold their spots here. Tech has just walked down to the B site and gets taken down by Orion. Completely walked out. I don't know how that happened. Still, shots going down on the cat. Walmart is going to get one. That's Savage with another one. Saucy trying to get some shots down mid here. It's only two people left. Two versus five for these T's. Now Archer aggressing on Cat. Is Lucca going to catch him off guard? Lucca does get the deagle. Now Archer, one deagle. And Saucy getting it on the Savage is starting to look kind of possible. No, the flank from Adam. Adam with the double kill, shutting them down. It looks so possible for them, but no. Adam says, no, thank you. I'm still taking this win, boys. Now 13-5 for Team Purple. Pulling away. We suck at Dota. They're really going to have to start making a comeback right now. This is when it happens. Going with a double op setup, actually, from the Terrorists and the CTs. Both teams going for a double op setup. So, that's definitely a peculiar, interesting thing happening. CT's playing a 2-1-2 setup. Kind of aggressing on the cat spot here. Adam pushing on long. T's just spread across the map. Like usual, waiting on something to happen. Savage is going to be peeked by Joke. No op shot's going to come through, though. Joke, is he going to be able to make something happen? Popflash is going to come out from the mid player there. Savage having to back off completely. Walmart's going back to CT spawn to see if he can pull anything out from this, but it's not looking like he's going to make crazy plays. He's going to play up close to the door, though. More of a one-and-done spot. Maybe catch a few off guard when they're running through. Maybe that's what he's looking for. Savage holding the angle onto catwalk here. Backing away to B and Joke. He's just waiting for him. Waiting on that peek. Trying to probe them. Still time's being completely ran out. 55 seconds left. Joke is going to peek. He's taken down by Archer, but Lulnut's going to get Savage. That's one op or down. Still two ops for the T's. They need to go for more plays, like, to actually try and get hit shots, but the T's still haven't even committed to any kind of strat here. They're just playing a default still at this point in the round, trying to wait for more openings before they really commit. Team Purple's really good at holding. That seems to be what's best right now for them, is just to hold, and, you know, we suck at Dota. Their strength was to actually go for the retakes, but not here. Now the cat aggression is going to happen. That's Tech and Lulnut moving up on the cat. Flash coming out from the CT. The peek happens. Archer! Oh my. The shot through the box there. Watching that little pixel peek. Two spray down from Walmart. Shuts down the cat players. And Saucy's the only one alive. Adam running out of ammo. He's going to go for the Kobe. Doesn't do any damage though. Saucy gets the first op shot. 15 HP. 1v3 for this man. Time has ran out and Saucy. He is going to just save his op. Probably the best idea. But they need rounds. The T's need rounds at this point. Purple is absolutely pulling away at the scoreline right now. It's not looking good for these Terrorists. Not at all. Here's the scoreline so far from these two teams. You guys make sure you support both of these teams. They did a very good job playing this match today. Terrorist completely rushing towards B. Tones are going to go out really fast into B. There's two CTs extra playing B. Going to catch him off guard. That's one for Walmart. Two for Walmart. Tech is going to trade out Orion. And now B side has been taken by the Terrorist. But it's not looking good. Archer with the flick on the Joke here. On mid. Going to take him down with the op. And now it's only two left. Going for that plant. 4v2 retake for the CTs. Definitely going to be looking good in their favor. And now the two Terrorists. Archer with the flick on attack. It's a 1v4. Can he do anything? Saucy gets one. He misses. Oh, man. He's taken out by Savage, though. No, thank you. It's over. That round completely given to Team Purple. And now we're looking at a 15-5 score for them. This could be the end of the game. We are looking at match point here. Team Purple just completely taking the win right now. It's not over yet, though. We have to wait and see. Terrorist did get a bomb plant, so they're going to be able to buy, but they're ever going to win out. Now is the time. They have no other choice. So, maybe they'll run some kind of strat, something to actually surprise us. Catch Team Purple off guard. Adam is going to pop flash. Nothing really happening there. No one's going to connect any shots. He's going to have to back off. Early long control from the Terrorist. Leaving that lurker into B tunnels there. That's a pretty smart play. The aggression out on the Xbox. That's Orion getting one frag. And then Adam shutting down Lucca. They're not able to make anything happen. It's now looking bad. We suck at Dota. 2v5. 1v5. It's only Saucy left. Walmart and Archer. One for Saucy. Is he going to be able to do this? You have to make a play happen. He gets one, but he's trapped. He's not really in a good position at all. Can't do much here. Still, CT is completely holding. We are seeing an aggression come out from Orion coming up on the flank. Molotov going to be thrown by Archer to try and catch him out. Now, he just threw a Molotov back. Nate, not able to. Oh, my. Oh, my. Orion's pushed right up behind him. He knows now. He misses the op shot. Oh, this is so awkward. He can't hit any of the op shots. He does hit the no-scope, but he is shut down by Savage. And that's the end of the match, people. CSG Purple taking the win. Final score, 16-5. What an absolutely great game. It was really close at the beginning, but the pull away from Team Purple was what they needed, and it really did secure the game for them. I enjoyed watching this, though. I really did. Both of these teams played very well, but congratulations, Team Purple, and I just like to thank everyone so much for coming out and watching the stream tonight. It's been a really fun night. I will put this on intermission now. There won't be any more matches tonight, but if you'd like for any information about casting, anything you'd like to know, tweet me at MrHickGG. Also, check out Cyberstorm. Check out our website and stuff. Thank you guys so much again, and I will see you in the next one. See ya.
choices that it's hard not to look past. What is real and what is fake, and the risk we have to take. Will we know what is throwing off our balance? Trying to find ourselves without the defining words. We can no longer hold on to what only makes us hurt.
We wanted to run, we wanted to fall together. Back then our world seemed so clear. We crystal bright, shimmering lights around us. We take flight into the sky. How many worlds would you cross to use the light that's right in front of you? There is no light on the other side, I say. Look straight ahead and you will see. You will see. You will see.
We'll see.